I'm good. I'm gonna get out in the water.
Okay.
I gotta get wet anyways.
True.
Okay, Garmin, stop recording.
Welcome to episode 5. At the end of episode 4, we had delivered our first load across the Silver Falls portage. As Andy McCarthy was making his way back to the head of the portage to get a second load, he came across the man collapsed on the trail. After examining him, he decided the man was in trouble and began to administer CPR to try to resuscitate him. Before I describe what happened next, let's go back and examine the footage I have so I can introduce two additional gentlemen who are crossing the portage along with us. Their families have requested that I do not use their last names. Two men from the Minneapolis area had plans to make the epic journey along the falls chain. They had arrived the same day we did, and we actually passed their vehicle here as we first arrived at the outfitters. In the morning, breakfast was on the agenda. As it turns out, both Andy and Craig were sitting at the table next to us. In this video here, Andy is the one just sitting down at the table in the plaid shirt, and Craig is the gentleman in the dark blue jacket sitting across from him. Both parties sat down and had a nice pancake, sausage, and orange juice breakfast with no clue as to what the day's events would eventually bring. We would later learn that both these gentlemen are 71 years old and both share a love for the great outdoors. While Andy had made this trip many times before, this was going to be Craig's first time into Quetico doing the falls chain. A couple of minutes after breakfast, both parties readied themselves down by the pier. Andy and Craig had their boat loaded right next to ours on the opposite side of the pier. You can see them walking towards their boat here as we're loaded in our boat getting ready to go. Our party had two boats, and Andy and Craig traveled in one boat, so we had three boats all traveling to American Point at the same time. Andy and Craig arrived at the ranger station ahead of us. As we pulled in, their canoe was at the pier and they were already in paying their fees. As we pulled up to Silver Falls Portage, their canoe was already there and they were in the process of carrying their first load across the portage. I carried my canoe past theirs, past Grant, and eventually I caught up to Craig, who was coming back, and he was resting up at the top of a hill. We had a brief exchange as we passed.
Whew. It's all downhill now.
Awesome.
From the GPS data, I was able to piece together that Craig would have only gone another 160 yards, and it took him about 3 minutes.
Because if I could see your face once more,
Andy would have found Craig in under 2 minutes.
When you said your last goodbye,
take my body. All I reach the portage at 12:30, which is about the exact time Andy discovers Craig on the trail. So this brings us back to the point in the story that I began, where I first became aware that Craig had collapsed and we are in need of the satellite phone. At 12:38, Mark Crosby and I head back down the portage towards Andy's position. Our goal is to get to my satellite phone, which is at the beginning of the portage. Reached Andy's position at about 12:42. Andy, Jim, and Grant were working on Craig on the ground at this location. By about 12:45, I had the satellite phone. However, I needed to go back all the way to the front of the trail so that I could get in a large open area to get a signal for reception on the satellite phone. Once I was at the head of the trail, I could get a signal and I tried 911. However, it did not work. In order for me to get a call out, I would need to have a number in Ontario for rescue services. Fortunately, after a period of time, Don Berkeltz was able to find a number on a brochure for Voyager Outfitters. After several attempts of dialing a number, I was able to get a hold of a rescue operator who could finally help. After explaining our situation, she requested our GPS coordinates such that she could send a flight for life to try to help rescue Craig. This request also turned out to be very time-consuming because I wasn't exactly familiar with how to extract those coordinates from my GPS program in my cell phone. After about 10 minutes of trying, I came up with a number. However, at this point in time, it was too late. After about 50 minutes of doing CPR, the team decided that they had to call it. They had absolutely no response back from Craig, and at that point, they figured there was nothing left they could do. With that determination, the rescue now became a recovery, and everything changed as I spoke with the rescue operator on the phone. While I was attempting to get help using the satellite phone, Craig's friend Andy realized that he had a shortwave radio that he could use to speak to the ranger back at Cache Bay. Within seconds, Janice Matichuk answered Andy's call and began to help arranging a recovery team. By about 2 o'clock, it became pretty clear that it was going to be quite a while before rescue workers and police were going to be able to reach our position and help extract Andy and Craig from Quetico. With this information, Janice realized it would be way too long for us to wait at the portage for police to arrive. So she asked for us to get cleared so that we could leave the portage and continue on our trip in order to make our camp destination before dark. This turned out to be the right decision because after we returned to the outfitters, we learned that it wasn't until 6:30 that they finally arrived at Silver Falls to help Andy and Craig leave Quetico. Since we returned from Quetico, we had an idea that we wanted to connect with Craig's family and provide them the video footage that we had taken, as well as share our story with them so that they could better understand what happened that day to Craig.
Oh my God.
Whew. It's all downhill now.
Awesome.
Craig was survived by a son, Todd, and a wife, Catherine, who we had been able to contact since that day in Quetico. Craig's wife, Kathy, has shared with me some information about Craig, which I would like to pass on through this video. Craig was an avid outdoorsman. Craig and his son had gone hiking in the Tetons as well as in the Appalachian Mountains. Craig was an avid outdoorsman, but he also volunteered for many worthwhile activities, and he really enjoyed scouting. Craig and Kathy shared 51 years of marriage after meeting in their high school physics class. Craig was a devout Christian working on reading his men's Bible for the second time. Kathy wrote me that Craig was the most hardworking, dependable, trustworthy, unpretentious man she has ever known. After watching my first three episodes, Kathy wrote me the following. I was surprised to find myself forgiving Quetico as I watched. I felt as if Quetico was speaking to me, telling me that it gave Craig a beautiful sunny day, a beautiful temperature, peacefully still waters with the wind at his back, and only asking a half hour of his life to paddle over to Silver Falls. I gave him my best, whispered Quetico. End quote. Well, dear Kathy, we're incredibly sorry that we could not save Craig that day for you. But we do hope that this video has helped in some way to help you come to terms with, obviously, your substantial loss. And from our team to you, we wish you all the best. We would also like to throw a thanks out to Janice Matichuk of the Cache Bay Ranger Station. Without her help, that day would have been much harder. And we would also like to thank the nameless operator on the end of the line that picked up the call when we placed it with the satellite phone. It was very helpful and reassuring to have somebody back in the civilized world at the other end of the line. So thanks for that. So let's finish out this episode by playing some of the clips from the past episodes of Andy and Craig for the last time. I hope you enjoy. Once the boats are loaded, both boats will be heading out a narrow rock channel, which...
Yeah, we're actually competing for survival against that boat.
Now, if I remember right,
it's not like gone.
Since Grant has not portaged a canoe, I decided to take the canoe for the first trip, possibly another pack on the front of them and things in their hands. So it'll be the first load. We're going to try to get all the gear.
You can only see like 12 feet in front of you. Oh, this is the monster rock or whatever it is.
Oh, awesome. Hey, Andy, I'm recording you recording me. Somebody dropped my sponge back there.
Like a veteran.
Alright.
Almost there. Get the camera going, gentlemen.
It's going.
In episode 6, we continue our adventure into the Quetico. So stay tuned for that.